training. So, we're not quite to the racetrack yet. There's homeboy. We parked here, and it's raining. This should be fun. Yeah. What?
Right here.
Hang on a second, dude.
Braves lost 2-0.
So, yeah, that was the end of that. Johnny Sauter won. I don't like him, so I'm not very happy right now. And now, me and homeboy are going to start the long road home. So, yeah.
Seconds, and Casey King with two leads, a total of 10 additional seconds. YRB!
So yeah, walking out of the pits, there is my dad. Just talked to several of the drivers tonight, and it's access you would never get at a NASCAR race. So yeah, this was a fun night.
They're all doing a great job with that car, and it's just a lot of fun to drive. So we're happy to be here, and it's great to be out here for the Dash Crawl. So thank you all the fans, everybody's coming out tonight. I hope you see a great race at the dirt track, and thank you all the veterans that are here also, and we keep everybody in our thoughts on this Memorial Day weekend. So thank you.
Logan Schuhart, not done yet. Reach in there and pull out your starting spot for the Sears Craftsman Dash. He has drawn the number 5. He will be on the inside of row 3, starting 5th in the Sears Craftsman Dash. Up next, it's the 9-time and defending Outlaw Champion, the current series point leader, the pilot of the Textron Off-Road, number 15, Donnie Schatz. Strong performance for you as well this evening, a heat race victory. You come back to Charlotte where you're always very strong. You won here on the opening night of the World Finals, and you currently are on top of the point standings once again. It's May, and you're right there in familiar position.
Yeah, it's right now the person that beats Mother Nature, and we're glad she's a race fan tonight, so we can get on a show for all you fans here in Charlotte, and have a great Memorial Day weekend.
Donnie, let's find out where you start in the Sears Craftsman Dash. Donnie Schatz reaches in and pulls out the outside front row starting spot. Number 2 for Donnie Schatz in car number 15. That brings us to the leading contender for the Kevin Gobrecht Award for Rookie of the Year honors this season in the number 18, Ian Mattson. Ian, you've struggled just a bit in your rookie season, but right now you come back to Charlotte with a strong performance. You finished on the podium here in the past with the World of Outlaws Craftsman Sprint Car Series.
Yeah, just thankful to be getting to race in after the last few weeks. It's been a bit miserable, but just happy to be here tonight, and thanks all the fans for coming out on Memorial Day weekend. It's pretty awesome to see all you guys here, and let's hope for a good result tonight.
Let's find out where you start in the Sears Craftsman Dash. Ian Madsen has drawn the number 3. He'll be on the inside of row number 2. Up next, the driver of the Aqua Phoenix number 07 is Gerard McIntyre. We're here in Charlotte, North Carolina, but we've got a lot of Pennsylvania Posse fans in the grandstands here, as we always do. Gerard McIntyre representing the Posse here tonight against the Outlaws, and you put the car in the Sears Craftsman Dash.
Yeah, I'm glad to be here right now. Yeah, we didn't really decide to come here until this morning, and everything seems to be going our way right now, and hopefully it keeps going that way.
Let's find out where you start in the Sears Craftsman Dash. Reach in there and pull out one of those wrenches. It is the number 6. He is on the outside of row 3. We've got 2 drivers left to draw, and one of them will be on the pole for tonight's Sears Craftsman Dash. Let's bring out the driver of the Ineos Oil number 2, Shane Stewart. Shane, you come out here as one of the last 2 drivers to draw, but the pole position's still open. Lots of good stuff in that toolbox.
Yeah, hopefully we can draw that number 1. That'd be great. We had a big week back at the shop. We, you know, being based here in Charlotte, we don't get back here very often, and everybody put their heads together. We've been struggling a little bit, and so hopefully all of our hard work this week is going to pay off and try to get a big win here. And it's always good to race in front of Kyle. I know he's going to be able to race with us a little bit on Monday and next week, but it'd be great to win here.
Let's find out where you start. Pole position still available for the Sears Craftsman Dash. Not anymore! Shane Stewart's got it! He's on the pole in car number 2! And that brings us to the driver of the Napa number 49. It's the big cat, Brad Sweet. Brad, the pole position no longer available, but you really had to battle just to find yourself out here on this stage for the Sears Craftsman Dash Draw. You fired a wicked slider to get back by David Gravel.
Yeah, the motor didn't take off real good there, and he got behind David. He's not very easy to pass usually, but the Napa car's working good, and it's just good to be in the dash. Like you said, we were out of the dash there for a lot of that heat race, and it had a couple fortunate breaks, and it had a good enough race car to get in. So nice to be here. I got a lot of friends and family here, and miss my wife back home. But we'll get some racing in hopefully here in the next few weeks, and hopefully tonight we can start get some momentum on our side and get a win here.
Just make it official. You gotta actually reach in and pull it. I believe it's the number 4 left. It is correct. The number 4, he's on the outside of row 2. So the starting lineup has been set for this evening's Sears Craftsman Dash.